Randall said the program has been a big success in America.
Yeah, well, this is here, I vote no.
Surely you could be more understanding for once.
Wouldn't have minded the gander in here before we knocked over that service station. Might have thought twice about going through with it.
Mm. I think we can all come up with a story like that.
Yeah, all the girls at Winlayton when I was there thought places like this were a bit of a laugh.
I'm sure there's no one in this room that would knock back a second chance, now that we all know what being locked up's like.
Well, Lexi, want to try arguing that one?
What are we going to teach them? First grade arithmetic?
We teach them by telling them how dreadful a place like this can be.
Oh, so we'll write them a book.
I don't want no teeny boppers nipping at me ankles.
Why are you so against it? Here's a golden opportunity to stop someone from making the same mistake you did.
Don't you mean we, sweetheart? You still got a dead granny to answer for, haven't you?
We're discussing a delinquent reform program.
Frankly, I think we'd be better off with a more selective participation.
Oh, don't you go acting all lily-white plum brain. And what are you going to teach them? How to rip off your mates? How to flog off stolen goods? Oh, you can't wait, can you?
What are you so upset about? It's only kids.
It's because I'm looking at a bunch of tin pot saints all playing goody-goody, trying to earn an elephant stamp from Renault. Putting those kids in front of you lot's like giving them on-the-job training.
She's got a point. It's pretty bloody hypocritical.
Not if we can stop them doing it themselves. If you can't see that, then you're thicker than I thought you were.
It makes sense. If we can help one kid, we'll have achieved something.
And how are we going to do that? By Graham teaching them how to smash up shops? Or you teaching them how to diddle the books? Or Flynn teaching them how to murder three hitchhikers in cold blood?
Yeah. Well, took you a while to get there, Kelly, but I knew you would eventually.
Huh? What do you mean?
I mean, that's exactly what we're going to do with these kids. Tell them what we did, why we did it, and why we shouldn't have done it. How we have to live with it for the rest of our lives. I reckon that qualifies all of us, don't you? Including you. Well, if no one's got anything more to say on the matter, we'll take a vote. All those in favour? Well.
That's all very well, but you treated Tim like some sort of idiot.
Well, I've got nothing against businessmen, except that they're dull, boring, and not at all your type.
He's a genuine guy who asked me out, and I said yes. How do you think he feels with all that feeding the kids stuff, honestly, Ben?
I loved the look on your face when the waiter said Mrs. Fulbright. You caught your jaw before it hit the ground.
Yes, no thanks to your friend the waiter. Talk about a pair of...
Oh?
Well, where would have you been if he turned out to be an old friend who knew we weren't married?
I'd have thought of something, I dare say. You know what they say about lawyers, frustrated actors, a lot of us.
Well, if I can't give you an Oscar, at least I can offer you a cup of coffee.
Look, I'd love one, but... I don't really have the time. I've got a rush. Important engagement.
Engagement?
Well,
I thought we'd arranged...
I can't go breaking dates. I'll see my own way out. Bye.
Ben!
Oh, what's it? Here comes a white-collar worker.
Hey, what are you doing here? Spill the ink or something?
No, there's just no more filing to do, that's all.
So they had to come and sweat with us slaves, huh?
At least they feed slaves properly. Hey, one more breakfast like that and I'll pass out.
Christ, they really must do something. I can't understand it.
Merv's doing his best.
A dry toast made out of stale bread and that tiny little bit of milk that he brought in. It's not good enough, Nora.
Yeah, I know, but it's the department we've got to have a go at, not Merv.
Yeah, if we're relying on him, we'd be skin and bone in a couple of days.
That's not fair, Lex. Nora's just said he's doing his best. Why do you always have to knock people?
Look, I wasn't. All I was saying was... Bloody hell, why are you picking on me? Just get off my back, will you?
Yeah, well, you should think before you do nasty things.
No, you should have been a school teacher, Chucky.
What do you want me to do, Nora?
Give a hand with the dryers, if you like.
Hey, Chucky, if you want to buy an under, you better hurry up. They're selling like hotcakes.
Hartley? Your trial's been set for tomorrow. Is there anything you want?
Well, I'll have to see my solicitor and...
A solicitor and a barrister will be here in the morning. Good luck.
Yeah, good luck, Jen. Sorry, couldn't help over here and...
Good on you, Jen. We'll all be barracking for you, love. You won't have to put up with us much longer.
Thanks,
May.
And as an official of this union, I hope that you will do something to see that this waste of time is stopped in its tracks.
Stop jumping head first, Miss Ferguson. We may be missing out on a golden opportunity here.
We're understaffed enough as it is. We can't waste time running around after a bunch of juvenile delinquents.
We all know that this is a PR exercise for the department, but we must approach these things in the right way. Now, as far as the public's concerned, this Scared Straight thing's a genuine attempt to help these kids. We know it won't work and the hassles we're going to have, but by the same token, we can't afford to be seen to be unsympathetic. And when the whole thing blows up in their faces, we want to be able to say we gave it our best shot. It was the prisoner's fault and the administration's fault. The only blameless party to the whole exercise will be our members. Now, I can't see that doing any harm to our long-term wages and conditions campaign, can you?
Morning. So,
the emergency food supplies have arrived at the front gate.
Oh, not before time. Thanks for telling me, Meg. Would you mind looking after it?
I'm afraid it's not that simple. There's a problem at the front gate. I think you better go and see for yourself.
Listen, sport, you haven't got a hope in hell of getting into this place. I just do a Yui and get lost.
Come off it, mate. If I don't deliver this stuff, I don't get paid. I'm not like you blokes. This is my own truck.
Well, it's the same with all of us, pal. And these bastards are giving us a really hard time. So I reckon that puts us all in the same boat.
Terrific. This is my first contract in 2 weeks.
Sorry, mate, but that's the story.
What's going on?
Who are you?
Anne Reynolds. I'm the governor of the prison.
Oh, I'm Harry Wheeler. We're all blockading this place until we see some action. We're all owner drivers, right? When the department goes and cancels its contract on Bullock, we all lose our livelihoods. We're not going to sit around and watch our jobs go down the drain.
How am I supposed to feed the prisoners in the meantime?
Forget it, Mrs. Reynolds. You've got a storeroom in there. Use it. I'm sorry, lady, but this is the only pool we've got.
Look, how about if I unload the stuff right here?
No way! That stuff's not crossing this line.
Sorry, lady. There's nothing I can do.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.